Good morning, everyone. Good morning, National and International Museum Day. So go to your favorite museum in the whole wide world. It's awesome. I challenged the folks here at the Cleveland Museum of Natural History. Show me stuff I've never seen before. They weren't playing. Went down to sub-level one. You guys saw that. Now I'm on sub-level two, and this is the wet collection, which I've never, ever seen. Jewels. This is crazy stuff. All right, so everything here, obviously, you guys keep in this. I guess this is water that has all kinds of stuff that makes it.
So it's all kept in alcohol. Everything is preserved in formaldehyde first to stop it from rotting.
Okay.
And then we move it into alcohol.
Cool. And then so everything down here, I see fish. What else do you guys have in the wet collection?
So we have fish, amphibians, reptiles, and also crayfish.
Wow. And I'm just looking at aisles and aisles and rows of everything, ranging from smaller fish. I see like two or three fish in a specimen jar.
Mm-hmm.
And range it. So these are like what?
So those are anchovies.
Okay, really? And these are?
Ooh, those are Brevoortia tyrannus.
Okay.
Of course.
Of course. And then you pulled some stuff over here. I mean, look at this. More aisles of stuff. Now this, you had this one. So what is this?
So this is a cat-eyed snake.
A cat-eyed snake.
Yep. So this is actually a South American species, and it was found on a bunch of bananas at a warehouse in Columbus.
Okay. No way.
Yeah.
So it was in Columbus, but it's a South American species.
Yep. So he hitchhiked on a bunch of bananas.
No way.
And ended up
from
in
South
Ohio.
America. So yep. I guess he ate bananas to stay alive.
Or he was hunting whatever's living in
the bananas. Was living in the bananas. Okay.
Yep.
Now look at this. What is this?
So this is a baby sturgeon.
Oh my gosh, that's a baby sturgeon.
A little tiny baby one. They can grow 10, 12 feet long.
That is amazing. That really puts it into perspective here. And mm-hmm. then Lamont, give him a wide shot. So aisles and aisles and aisles of this. So, I mean, we're talking thousands of specimens, way more than that, probably, right?
Probably tens of thousands.
Tens of thousands of specimens. So someone has to catalog these, know where they are, know,
yep.
you know. And then would these be used for research or just for history? Or, so, let's talk about these.
They can be used for whatever questions any scientist might have.
Mm-hmm.
Because they're preserved, sometimes using special techniques, you can still get DNA out of them.
Wow.
You can test them for environmental factors.
Huh. So you name it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If you have the question, you can.
They're not living specimens, but they're great specimens that can still teach us a lot.
Mm-hmm. And we have some that are over 130 years old.
No way. In the wet collection right here at the Cleveland Museum of Natural History. Go to your favorite museum today because it's International History Day. Thank you so much, Jules.
Yeah.
When we come back, lots to show you guys.